Hey, good evening, friends. Sorry, we are again late. Got busy in some work. Anyway, we are going to talk today about spinal tumors. Spinal tumors generally, no differentiation between a pediatric age population and adult population. So, spine, as you must be knowing, I'll explain, there are two kinds of structures. So, there is a bony structure and there is a soft tissue structure. So, the bony structure would be consisting of a vertebral body with all its parts, and then the soft tissue structure would be the dural tube, that is the tube which comes up down from the brain and goes down, and which contains the neural structures from the cord and the nerves at every level. So, how would somebody come to know about that he can be having or he may be suffering from a spine tumor? So what are the symptoms? Local pain is number one. Number two is excruciating pain, which is radiating in any side of the body. It may be pertaining to the, it depends on the part of the spine where it is involving, and it can be the radiating pain in the arms, it can be radiating pain on both the sides of the chest or the abdomen, or it can be radiating pain down the legs. Apart from this, it can produce weakness, it can produce difficulty in walking, and few more related symptoms. So the treatment would depend on what is the kind of tumor, where it is, which part it is involving. The MRI would be the investigation choice, and it would define regarding the nature of the tumor mostly. In about 10% of the cases, we are not very sure before the surgery what kind of a tumor it may be, because it is a little confusing. Now, if we divide the soft tissue tumors of the nerves, then they can be intramedullary. That means it is inside the cord, and there would be tumors which are outside the cord but inside the cover. That's the leather kind of a cover which the nervous structures are, neural structures are surrounded by. So the tumor can be between the cover and the nervous structure. Then there can be the tumors which are involving or coming out of the nerves per se. So these are the three types of tumors, and the worst kind are in which are intramedullary. That means the tumors which are coming from the cord, which are existing within the cord, and they can be quite significantly bad at times, because even if you operate, that would not lead to any significant improvement, or at times they do not have a clear plane of cleavage, so that when we are operating, we are removing the tumor, we are not sure whether we have reached the end of the tumor or it is the beginning of the cord, and it can lead to deterioration neurologically at times. So as I was telling you, so the main investigation would be MRI. After that, there are other investigations which would be helping with the primary investigation. It can be a CT scan, it can be a myelogram, it can be an X-ray, and a few more. Now, the mainstay of the treatment would remain to be the surgery only, because medically these cannot be treated until unless they are infections or they are some other kind of lesions apart from tumors. Most of the tumors in the spine are benign in nature. That means they are not cancerous, they are slow growing, they exist for a longer time, they are existing there for a longer time before the detection, and they do not return back after the surgery. Very few tumors are recurrent in nature, which come back, and they can spread to the surrounding parts of the spine. Another part of the tumor can be tumors of the central nervous system, which can be coexisting in the brain and the spine both, and there are very, very few which can come from the other structures of the body, which are known as secondary tumors. So when the surgery is to be considered, then the surgery has to be, whether we have to do it anteriorly or it has to be done posteriorly, it depends on the location of the tumor, the kind of the tumor that we find out on the MRI and diagnose it on the MRI, which is a tentative or a provisional diagnosis. Then if we do it from the anterior, there are the tumors which are usually the bony tumors like sarcomas or chordomas, They usually produce local pain symptoms and pressure symptoms on the surrounding structures. So when we operate, it would be anteriorly preferably. When we remove it completely, we resect the complete body, we replace it with artificial other structures and substitutes of vertebral bodies. It can be one level or more at times. And then the biopsy, the histopathology that would be available after a period of 3 to 5 days, depending on different institutes. We would be treating it as per the histopathology, whether it would be a radiation, it would be a radiation plus chemo, or it would be just, it should be left just like this, and the patient should be observed with a follow-up of following MRIs and the other relevant investigations. Most of the tumors would be done from behind, wherein we remove the lamina, the thinner part of the spine from the back, and then we reach inside. We remove the cover of these the neural structures, and most of the tumors would be around that part, so which are extramedullary, intradural, or purely dural, or they are coming out from the exiting nerve roots. And the most important tumors, which are I would say a challenge for the neurosurgeons, are the intramedullary tumors, the tumors which exist within the cord. So therein we have to dissect the cord, not dissect exactly, it has to be in a longitudinal direction. In the direction of the cord, the incision has to be given in the midline, then you reach the dissect. The dissection has to be fine, because any kind of misappropriate job or activity done on the cord can lead to significant amount of neurological deterioration. So that is why, apart from the surgeon, the other things which are important are the surgeon and the technique one, and then the microscopes, the operating instruments available, and a few tumors may require an instrument which is known as CUSA, which is Cavitron Ultrasonic Aspirator, and most of the high-end neurological centers, neurosurgical centers would have it. The smaller hospitals usually lack in these facilities. So the patients should decide on their own when they are detected with such tumors, they should get operated at a higher neurosciences center, a neurological specialized center, by the surgeons who are experienced in such cases, and then the results can be the best. That's it for today. Thank you very much. Good night.